Alright, this is Big DMC1, and today I'm going to show you how I reload my 45 ACP with my Lee Progressive Reloader. Today I'm kind of doing this to do two things. I'm testing out my new digital camera. It's a Canon EOS 60D, and I'm also testing out a new microphone input system I'm using. I've got the Telefunken M411 microphone right here, and that's fed into a digital recorder, and that's fed into the camera, and we're simultaneously recording on the camera and the digital recorder. We'll see which one sounds the best and pick which one we want then. Okay, we've loaded all of our brass, we've cleaned it, and we put it in the top and shaken it all down, and now we've got to, better fill the powder back up. I've already set it up, and all I have to do now is top off some of that, make sure the primers are installed. You don't want to run out of primers. Let's get some started here. Oh, yeah. It's got an automatic bullet feeder, so until you get the bullets, the case is all lined up. It's going to start spitting them off on the ground. All right, now we're ready to start loading. Everything is cycled up to the point. We are getting low on primers. Once it exits the little primer tray here, it's time to put new primers in. You don't want it to get too low where it's not in the little white plastic feed tube here. So, to put primers in these things, I'm using a CCI large pistol primer. It's fairly easy. I think they have a square version of this that actually fits this just right, but this is still pretty easy compared to the other brands. I really shopped around and studied all the loaders that were available. And I used, before this, I used the Lee Progressive 1000, which it worked, but it took a lot of ingenuity to make it work right. It's pretty good for the beginner, but I'm glad I picked this one. I considered real close the lock and load, but the shell plate holders were more expensive. The holders for the dies, you had to buy individual ones, which cost more than this one that holds all five. The auto bullet feeder is more expensive. The auto shell case feeder is more expensive. You have to pick your one thing that really iced it for me is you have to pick your primers up one at a time with a little tube and drop them in this little tube, or I can just take this here and I turn it upside down, drop them in. Might lose a couple on the corners because this is round and that's square. Shake it and they should all be upside down, or except maybe one stubborn one, and you flip it over by hand. But the majority of them, you shake it and they will all be in the right position. Put the lid back on. And where's my pencil? You take a pencil, poke it in there, that way it keeps them all from all coming out. Slide it back in, shake it to get it started, and you will have to watch it because the first few loads that you want to shake it more than what this thing can actually shake it to get it to work right. So let's see here now if we're back rolling. Yep. So I'm real happy with the Lee Progressive 2000. It's for the money, it's I think the best one out there by far. And we're running low on powder again. I use the N320, 5.2 grains with a 200 grain moly coated lead bullet. I use it for just target practice or wild bunch. It's good for wild bunch shooting because it's a lead bullet, not jacketed. And again, I can only load them to about here because they are a hollow base, so it tends to flip the bullet upside down if you load too high because it puts too much pressure on the round nose and in the base. But you can load it all the way to the top if you have a flat bottom bullet. So that's about it. Once it's set up, you can just crank them off all day long. Without using any hands, you could just keep stop every once in a while and fill this up, or you could just keep adding one at a time. But it's kind of fun just to fill them up, and that way you can keep an eye on stuff. Keep poking it in because there's some of these brass are all dinged up on the edges, and if they're poking up on the little that's it, that's the last bolt off lands, they won't load right. You see that's the one that didn't load right. It's got some boogers up, little scars right here. And when you're done, just I got the factory crimp, so it that's the final stage is the factory crimp. We go deep primes it, puts a primer in on this stage, powders it, seats the bullet, and factory crimp here. And when we're done, we just load it up. Plenty of little bullets we can go practice with. Thanks for watching. This is Big DMC1 out.